Good morning, students. Hope all of you are doing well. Today we are going to study rules of disability. So previous year you have studied. We are just going to a revision now. So first one, divisible by 2. How we will shape a number is divisible by 2. Okay. So for that you have already studied that a number is divisible by 2 if the digit in its ones place is divisible by 2. So, you know the place values and all. If you got a number, if I am taking a number 72, how will you check that this number is divisible by 2 or not? We have to check the ones place of this number. We have to check the ones place of this number. Which is the ones place? This is one place. This is tens place. Is it? So, 2 is in ones place. If this digit in ones place is divisible by 2, you can say that the whole number is divisible by 2. Okay, that means what you want to check? You have to check the digit in ones place of the given number. If that digit is divisible by 2, means you can divide the whole number by 2. Or easily you can say in another method, in ones place 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. That means if you got a number like this, you have to check the ones place. If in one place 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. In this, any one one digit came in, you can say that that number is divisible by 2. Okay. So, first one, how will you check that the number is divisible by 2? You have to check the digit in its ones place is divisible by 2. Or you can say, you can check that digit in one place is either 2, either 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Now, any of this digit came in the one place, means you can divide that number by 2. Okay, for example, 25. Can you divide this number by 2? No. Easily you can say that because in one place it is 5. So it can't divide by 2. And if you are taking 34, in one place 4 is there. So it is divisible by 2 because 4 came in one place. So you can say that this number is divisible by 2. If you are taking 63, can you divide? No, because 3 is in ones place. So this number you can't divide by 2. Okay, so that is divisibility of 2. That means how will you check a number is divisible by 2? You have to check ones place 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Any number, any of this digit came in ones place, you can divide that whole number by 2. Okay, next one, divisible by 5. How will you check a number is divisible by 5 or not? If it has 0 or 5 in ones place. So simply you can check how you can check that whether 0 or 5 is there in the ones place. That means if you are taking number 71, what about this, whether 71 is divisible by 5? No, because in ones place 1 is there. One place what should come? 0 or 5 should come. Then only you can divide that number by 5. Here 71, that means 1 only came in the 1 digit. So it can't divide by 5. And the number if I am taking 84. Can you divide this number by 0 or 5? No. Because in one place 4 is there. So this also you can't divide by 5. And what about 30? Easily you can divide. Why? Or if I am taking the larger number, 130. If I am taking the larger number, 130. What about this? 1 place 0 is there. So you can easily divide this number by 5. And 5475. What about this number? 5475. Simply you have to check 1 place. What is in 1 place? 5 is there in 1 place. So you can divide by 5. If I am taking another number, 8761. What about this one? You can't divide because 1 is there in the ones place. 5 is not there. Like that, divisible by 10 also you can check whether you can divide a number by 10. How will you check? If it has 0 in its ones place. If 0 came in its one place only, you can divide that number by 10. Okay. So if I am taking a larger number, 98764. What about this number? 98,764. Can you divide this number by 10? No. Why? In ones place, 4 is there. So 0 not came in. It is not divisible by 2. Not divisible by 2. Sorry, not divisible by 10. Okay, the next number if I am taking 9, 8, 7, 4, 5, 0. What about this number? Definitely you can divide this number by 10, because in one place what is there? 0 is there. So you can divide this number by 10. Okay, so I'll explain once more how you check divisibility of a number by 2. How you check in ones place what should come? 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Any of this number should come in ones place, then only it can divide by 2. Okay, if I'm taking a larger number, 9, 4, 8, 9, 2. Can you divide this number by 2? Yeah, definitely. Because in one place, 2 is there. So you can divide this number by 2. Okay, so the next one, divisibility by 5. In one place, what should come? 0 or 5 should come here. In one place, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, any of this number should come. And here, 0 or 5 should come in. If you want to divide a number by 5, 0 or 5 should come in ones place. And here, if you want to divide a number by 10, completely, that means what I'm saying here means you have to divide completely without reminder, you have to divide. Okay, that means this also you can divide by 2, but you can't, but not completely, a reminder definitely will come here. This number you can divide completely without any reminder. If you are dividing here this number by 2, this reminder will be definitely 0. Okay, here if you are dividing, one reminder definitely will be there. That only we are checking here, that means a number is completely divisible by 2, 5 or 10. Okay, here what you should check in one place, 0 or 5 should come. Here in one place, 0 should come. Okay, next we are going to check divisibility of 4. So how you check divisibility of 4? You have to check the last 2 digits on its extreme right. Last 2 digits in its extreme right. That means I have taken 2 numbers here. 96,852 and 61,394. The last 2 digits on its extreme, and that means 1s and 10th place. Here also 1s and 10th place. You have to consider the last 2 digits of the extreme right hand. That means the number formed by the last 2 digits of the extreme right hand. What is the number formed by the last 2 digits of the extreme right hand? Here 52 is the number formed by the last 2 digits of the extreme right hand. Okay, so what you should do means you should check whether this 52 is divisible by 4. How will you check? You can check by normal division. That's it. Whether 52 is divisible by 4, you have to check through normal division. So how you check? You have to get the remainder as 0. Okay, 1 4 is 4, 5 minus 4 1, 12, 3 4 is 12. Yes? What you got as the remainder? Remainder you got as 0. That means this 52 you can divide completely by the number 4. So what? You can divide the total number, this number by 4. So once more I will explain, you have to check the extreme right hand. You have to check the digits in the extreme right hand. That means how many digits you have to check? 2 digits in the extreme right hand you have to take. The number formed by these 2 digits you have to take separately. That is 52 you have to take separately, and want to check whether that number is completely divisible by 4. Okay, so 52, I checked here, 52 is completely divisible by 4, you got remainder 0 only, is it? That means 52 is completely divisible by 4. So, from here, what you can say that the number formed by the last 2 digits is extremely divisible by 4. So, the whole number you can divide by 4. Understood? Okay, like that, I will check this also. Okay, so what is the number formed by the last 2 digits? 94 is the number formed by the last 2 digits. Is it? Then 94, I am going to check whether it is divisible by 4. 2 4s are 8. 9 minus 8, 1, 14. 3 4s are 12. What reminder here? You got reminder as 2. Is it? You got reminder as 2. So what you can say from here, this 94 you can't divide completely by 4. That means a reminder is coming here. That means you can't divide this whole number by 4. That means this number is not divisible by 4. Okay? So you have to check the extreme right hand. and you have to check the last two digits on its extreme right hand. If that number is divisible by 4, you can say that the whole number is divisible by 4. Okay, just like this, you can check whether a number is divisible by 8. What you should check? Check the last three digits on its extreme right hand. Check the last three. Here for 4, you have to check the last two digits. And for here 8, you have to check the last three digits on its extreme right hand. What are the last three digits? Two numbers I took here. 79,152 and 57,348. Okay. So, what we should do? We have to divide this 152 by 8. If it is, if you are getting remainder as 0, you can say that this number is divisible by 8. Okay. And you have to take 348. If that 348 is divisible by 8, that means without a remainder, you can divide means you can divide this complete number by 8. Okay. We will check that. So, we should take the last three digits of the given number. So, 152 is the last three digits. We have to check what? We have to check whether that number is divisible by 8, completely divisible by 8. That means without any remainder, we should divide this number. So, 1, 8 is 8, is it? 7, 15 minus 8 is 7, 72, 9, 8 is 72, remainder you got as 0, is it? That means this 152 you can divide by 8. Say this 152 you can divide by 8. So you can divide this 79,152 by 8. Okay. And you will check what about 348. You have to check whether it is divisible by 8. Say 4 8 is 32. 34 minus 32. 2 28. 8 3 is 24. 8 minus 4 is 4. So, what you got? You got remainder as 4. So, 40, that means 348 divided by 8 is not, that means you can divide, but a remainder is coming here. Reminder. A remainder is there. That means you can't divide this number completely by 8. That means this number is not divisible by 8. Understood? So, you have to check the last three digits. And want to check whether that number formed by that last three digits is divisible by 8 or not. Okay.